I suppose, in some respects, in my mind, Grace is my attempt at writing an Irish Huckleberry Finn or an Irish Candide with a 14-year-old girl at the centre. It's set during the Irish famine. It opens at the start of the Irish famine with Grace, a 14-year-old girl who her mother cuts her hair quite brutally short and sends her out onto the road. And it seems to be an act of aggression, sending her out to bring home food for the family. But it's also an act of kindness because she's protecting her from a certain person. And so this is the beginning of a 5-year odyssey, a 5-year road trip where she has to learn how to fend for herself, but at the same time, as she grows up on the road, she's also encountering the increasing worsening of the Irish famine. And so, it is essentially a world of cosmic and moral collapse, where it's an apocalypse, it seems, but it's not quite that at the start, because we don't know. Grace can't know what's unfolding, and so the book really puts her to the test. It asks her to survive, and it asks of the reader, what does one have to do to survive in a situation like this? I don't choose my characters. I don't even choose my books. They choose me. Grace is actually the daughter of Col Coyle from my first novel, Red Sky and Morning. And so I realize, before I knew who Grace was, that she was a teenage girl, and that's all I knew. And these feelings come up through your subconscious, and very often your subconscious knows way ahead of you what it is you're going to be doing, but you're consciously not aware. So the act of writing is the act of divination, where you're trying to let your subconscious speak. And so I discovered, after I started writing the book, that she was Grace, that she was the daughter of Col Coyle, which surprised me. And then I realized that it would be going back to Donegal, I'd be going back into territory that I'd been in before, but also it would be opening up at the start of the famine, because she's 14 at the start of the famine. And I went, I don't want to do this. I don't want to write a follow-up to Red Sky and Morning. I don't want to write an Irish famine novel, because why would you want to do that? It's our great national trauma, and it's a very serious, challenging thing to take on. But as I said, my books choose me. And so after a couple of weeks, I realized that there was a reason why this character was beginning to speak through me, and there was a reason why this novel, I felt this novel needed to be written. And the fundamental thing that I wanted to explore was the silence that came out of that famine. There's a silence of which the Irish never really spoke about what they went through. They never spoke about what they did to survive. And so Grace was my means of trying to understand this. And I think what the novel taught me is that to survive an event like this, survivors are rarely heroes.